Hello, my beautiful people. Good morning and welcome back to the channel. I am going to be making this simple recipe for sore throat and cough. Like I have been attacked in Nigeria, but since I have all this in hand, I have to make it. It's just few ingredients you may have in your kitchen. Let's get started. Thank you for coming. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.
Have this few pieces of turmeric, okay? Then this is the lime. So for you to get a good water, you have to squeeze it this way. This way will help you to get enough juice from it. But they are so tiny, they don't have enough juice. So what I have been doing, the best method for you to get enough juice from lime is to squeeze it on the floor. Like you can use your leg to roll it, but since there's no need for that, my hand is okay, it's not very soft. So you do the other one too. Drink this concentration, just a little bit of it. I'm not gonna use all, okay, even though. Yeah, this is enough. Now is the lemon. I want to juice it out. So why I'm using the filter is because of the seeds. We want every content, every liquid that comes out to go in smoothly. So the lemon we have here in Nigeria does not have enough water. That is why you have to like squeeze it a little bit as we rolled it on the island before. And make sure you press the water. It's not going to be a waste. I'm still going to boil this lemon for my morning tea. Yeah. So this helps to eliminate sore throat. You see now, see the line now is now filled with water. Look at that, water coming out. On a normal day, if you opened it like that, you won't get this water. So please wash your hand, and this is my juice also. You may look at it as messy, it's not messy, it is clean. I'm gonna take it, it's not for everybody. So, and the one that has sore throat, and I have treated it with this recipe, I said, why not? Why don't I share with my family people? So that if anyone that has sore throat or you have cough, you can make this for yourself. You see, this is enough. What I'm going to be adding is honey. Alright, honey is good for our health. Like I said, I always say eating food or taking sweet food is not that bad. But it's bad when you overtake them. You have to take them in a moderate way. I prefer honey if I want to make my food sweet. Of course, there's no sugar in this house, just like in USA. I never bought sugar one day. This is too much. I'm going to also reduce it. Alright, so let me go with this one first. Yeah, so you add the honey inside. So there's nothing wrong with taking natural drinks, natural remedy, but what is wrong is when you don't know what you are taking. Like somebody bringing a bottle of juice for you, say this is a natural remedy. It's made up of ngongo na ngongo, you know, different things you don't even know. Alright, so I have made that mistake before and I'm not going to make it again. For me to take anything, I have to know what is inside, what I am taking. You cannot just bring a bottle for me to take, even though I like natural remedies. So tell me it is for weight loss, tell me it is for high blood pressure, tell me it's healthy. I will ask you, what are the contents? And even though you tell me the content, I will not be sure of taking them unless I go make them by myself. And I will read about them and know their effect. If we say ginger is for anti-inflammation, acts as anti-inflammation, I should go into Google, research about ginger, and find out what researchers, because those people have done the research and they use animals, and they find out what and what this medicinal plant does to the system. Okay, so when you go to Google, you find out everything you need to know, everything. Anyone you can find out, know that there's no much research on that. All right, so this concentration, this is nice. So the taste is always lovely because of the honey. And do you know that honey is not bad? Taking a moderate honey helps your body system, also helps you to, you know, heal your wound inside. Like some women, especially, or people that had accidents, especially people who are giving birth, if you are giving birth through CS, you know that it's good, better for the cut to heal from inside. So when you're taking honey, it will help your wound to heal faster from the inside. Okay, yeah, this is the concentration, and your sore throat is gone and gone forever. Don't say forever, because when you are exposed to bacteria, you're exposed to dust, it will still come. Okay, but your sore throat will definitely go. Take it just like this. The taste is so lovely, but you feel the hotness of ginger, right? And also the concentration of lemon and lime. Right, I want to say thank you for watching this one. Take care of your health, just as we did now. Me, myself, like I said, I have started walking out. So I walk on the streets. It's dusty. The street is not tied. So from my house to the tight road is a bit distance, but every morning I have to go work out, and that made me to inhale a lot of dust, and before you know it, I started reacting to it. And again, it's also a sign of malaria, because I have been bitten by mosquitoes several in this house. After fleeting, the mosquitoes will still appear. But all the same, this is our country, this is our home, we are not running away. Like, my son is lucky that he has his net, okay? So I put him inside his net. But anytime you bring it out, mosquito will pim, bite my son on his forehead. That's when you know that they are waiting for him. Alright, but I pray that God will always protect him from mosquito. Amen. He's too small to start feeling sick or having malaria. Alright, thank you. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel. You're welcome. Till I see you in my next one. Bye-bye.